Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome please the 1985-86 Northern Champions and runners-up in this year's National Concert Band Festival representing England, the Scalby School Wind Band.
Calvin Smith, ladies and gentlemen, with our smashing crowd. Now, the last time she played that with the band was in the Harrogate International Centre, which, I don't know if you've been there, but it's an absolutely massive place, and you don't half feel lonely in a place like that without music to play. And she was saying just before we came along that, in fact, she was more nervous playing to a home crowd than she was playing away there. So, anyway, a great success and a nice sound. Well, I can now, I suppose, officially welcome you to this evening of Scalby School Entertains, and there's certainly plenty for you to watch and to keep your eye on. And I have been warned, if you like, by one or two of the parents that they will be watching very carefully also exactly how we're all dressed. And I think I know that when they say that, they really mean how I'm dressed tonight. So I've chosen the DJ suit to start off with tonight. Is that all right? Yes, thank you very much. Right, okay. No applause. Right, straight on with the wind band show. And this is one that's fairly new to the repertoire, but it's nice and lively. I can't hear the band now. I said, it doesn't matter, just watch me. That's what a Sousa march is about. But a complete contrast now.
Thank you.
£3,000 worth of instruments there. Yes. But ever so well played. How about the changeover from that deep, deep sound and being able to pick up the small alto there and play like that? Caroline Elegant. You may have noticed, those of you that could read your programmes in this gloom, it's a very smart-looking programme, but you may have noticed that the two solos that we've done have both been written by a chap from Doncaster called Ray Woodfield. And it was very interesting to realise when we went off to do the audition, the Northern area, for the National Concert Band Festival, we'd no idea who the adjudicator was. We chose our programme and went on there and played. And there's no prizes for guessing who the adjudicator was. Ray Woodfield. And of course, when I came off and the other bands were saying, oh, well, it's all right for you now, I mean, you're playing Ray Woodfield's pieces. I said, was he the adjudicator? And, oh, yes, yeah, you mean you didn't know? I said, well, if you think about it, that's very dangerous. I mean, if he's written a piece and we carve it up, then I'm sure that's not going to do us any good. But as it turned out, we managed to get that award, and so Carolyn must have played it just how he liked it. Anyway, it's our last item now for the wind band, and it's the good old favourite, Dambusters.